realizes in humans of all sizes.
One thing that was concerning to investigators was the fact that the catastrophic nature of this type of error was not emphasized in training or manuals. It didn't build in any redundancies that would prevent a single point human error that would lead to a catastrophic outcome.
These guys should know the mission inside out.
The kind of whole different pilot standard than a normal pilot is for commercial or general aviation. They felt that a flight test pilot would be able to perform perfectly on time.
No wonder they didn't expect mistakes.
Training records show that the co-pilot flew a total of 112 simulator runs for this mission.
Point 8 mile. Come in.
Simulator training was extremely important for these pilots. It allowed them to run through the scenarios, get comfortable with the scenarios prior to getting into the actual aircraft. These pilots particularly were in the simulator about 14 times in the few months leading up to the accident. So they were extremely familiar with what the test card read and the procedures that they were to follow.
Never once did the co-pilot
demo
off the feather early.
The records reveal that while Ulsbury never made the deadly mistake in training, he did on one occasion make a different mistake. He unlocked the feather too late.
12 degrees. 14 degrees.
In order to ensure that the feather system works properly, the mission would be aborted if it wasn't unlocked by Mach 1.8.
If they didn't unlock by 1.8, they would have had aborted the flight. And we had seen in the simulator session data that the co-pilot had unlocked late.
So we have to go before launching Mach 1.8. If he's late, the mission is aborted.
Aborting a mission is not fatal, but investigators wonder, did this error in training from months ago somehow play a role in the crash?
Fire.
Could it help explain what went wrong aboard Spaceship 2? Seconds from rocket ignition to total destruction. How did the Spaceship 2 test flight go so wrong so quickly? Investigators believe time pressure may be one reason why.